very much honored to be here. And I express my humble and sincere gratitude for the esteemed rector of the university for inviting me. I really feel honored that I am becoming some part of active teaching learning process of this university. So esteemed rector, professor, my rector, pro-rector, distinguished colleagues, distinguished professors of this university, and other faculty members. I always call all the faculty members as colleagues, because basically I am a teacher. Basically I am a faculty member. So everyone I address as colleague. So I am very happy to be here. And I would like to tell you that generally what happens when you are interested to talk about, when you are interested to deliver some lecture, you are invited by someone. But the case is reverse for me. I approach the professor that I want to visit your university and I want to talk on some topics which are related to research. He is extremely, you know, competent, extremely expert, extremely distinguished professor. I am a very junior person. I have around 20 years of teaching experience. So senior people are here. I still believe that I have to learn a lot. And I never stop learning. And I will also tell you, how does this research empower you? How does this research help you in the learning mode? And I tell you one thing, if you feel that you can learn a lot throughout your life, you will be always happy. The secret of happiness lies in learning. The moment I feel that I no longer require any learning now, my progress will stop there and I may not be that much happy. So wherever I go, whatever I do, whatever I talk about, I always have one selfish motive. Forgive me, and that selfish motive is I always try to get something from wherever I go. So this may be a teaching learning experience for all of us. But what I'm going to take from here is, I will tell you, I'm going to take a lot of things with me when I go back to MIIT. That I always do. Because I always believe that learning never stops. Learning is to be there. So I approached the professor and he kindly consented that why not you come to our university someday and you talk about it. He has very nicely, given my introduction. His one line is enough for me, I tell you. If he say anything about me, one line, that's enough for me. But he has very nicely given my introduction. And whatever you have noted, that I will slightly talk about also, actually all these things are not required. When you go to US and European country, they will simply write GRC, they will not even write PhD. But I have included all these things deliberately. I have included all these things, a glimpse of awards and other things, intentionally. I have a purpose. I have a purpose of including this. If I can publish 218 research papers in just 19 years of my career, anyone can do that. And therefore, I have included all these things. So my topic is learning research-based skills towards academic excellence. Let us understand. We are all part of academics. We are all parts of academics. And why we are in the academic field? We want to contribute something for the society. Our ultimate aim is not to produce the graduates. Our aim is to serve the society. Our aim is to serve the mankind. Our aim is to do something for the larger cause of the society, larger cause of mankind. I think with that broad objective, we should always work. We should not only think that, you know, our aim is to teach this course, teach this subject, and by that teaching, some student will learn knowledge and they will become graduate. Not at all. That is one small part of our work, I tell you. And I'll tell you how. And therefore, what I have chosen is academic excellence. Let us strive for excellence. Whatever we are doing, let us try to excel in the academic endeavor, in the academic interest, in the academic, the areas. And therefore, I have chosen why learning research-based skills. Why to develop this skill? I have done my PhD. I became professor. I became this and this designation I got. Now, why do I do research? I did research for becoming, getting PhD degree. I wanted to be a professor. I got it. Why to continue? I tell you why to continue. It will always make you always, 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 always happy, and it will serve you. It will help you towards this great journey, that is academic excellence. Academic excellence is a journey, I tell you. It's a journey. No one can say that now I have achieved that academic excellence. I can, or no one in the universe can say. So one should always try for academic excellence. And towards academic excellence, this research-based approach, the skill set which we can learn, which we can acquire, which we can develop through research, greatly helps us. So let me put through the agenda, my lecture outline, what I am going to talk about today. And you can see that I have included one diagram. Again, this is intentional. So my talk is not going to be one direction. I want you all to please involve me in the lecture. Wherever you feel that you can interrupt me, wherever you feel that you can ask questions, wherever you feel that no, something is not clear, you please stop me, because ultimately we all are teachers, we all are colleagues. I will never mind if you ask me, if you interrupt me a number of times. And therefore, I want to make it more interactive. Therefore, other side also I have included. I don't want only one person talking and talking. I want to involve others also to get engaged in this learning process. And therefore, I never say that if someone asks me, what do you do? I generally answer, I'm engaging myself in some teaching learning process. I never say that I'm teaching. Teaching is never separated from learning. So with this objective, I just try to set in the agenda that what I'm going to talk about. I'll talk about motivation part. Why research? Whatever we do in our life, if we are doing some job here, if the students are studying here, you are doing some business outside, everything must begin with why. Big why. Why research? Why do I get after studying this course? What will I achieve? So why is very, very important thing in our life. If I want to do anything in my life, personal, professional, technical, anything, I must begin with why. If I don't understand why, there is no use of doing that. I give one simple example. You all are very nice teachers. I forgot to mention one thing, I'm sorry. I thought of beginning with that. I'm very happy to be here in Myanmar. It's because of what impressed me about this particular country, great nation, is the simplicity, is the humility, is the honesty of people. So I'm much impressed whenever I go to my country, I talk about the great values of this great nation. In fact, if you learn this research-based skill, you can contribute something to the society. What? I want to tell you. There is a newspaper, Global New Light of Myanmar. I got across that newspaper. I thought of, why can't I contribute something in that newspaper? And I started writing for that newspaper. A number of times my article was published. General article, skill development for young minds of Myanmar. How to develop employability skills in the young minds of Myanmar. So this research-based approach, it always helps you. So what I'm trying to tell you, if I have come to this country and I got to know about the great values, the honesty, simplicity. In our school, sir, there is one, a very free, big freezer. You all are aware about this thing. Cold drinks and all water bottles are there. No lock is there. There is a box which the students come and put the money and they get the drinks outside. No cashier is there. It's unique example, I tell you. It's unique example of honesty. So I talk about and I try to write in terms of articles. And it get published also. So this is how I keep myself engaged. So to begin with, I must thank all of you. I must express my very humble gratitude to the all great people of this great country that I have been, you know, I got opportunity to work for some time in this country. I feel very, very happy, extremely happy for that particular thing. So I'll talk something about motivation. Let me tell you one thing. This talk, today's talk is not that much technical. Please understand. It's going to be a general purpose talk. How one can, you know, start, how one can initiate this process, how one can make it a continuous process. That's my approach. I just want to ignite all of you and make a part of my team. As professor was talking about, I'm ready to come here on Saturday and Sunday. If someone, I mean, expresses his or her interest, sir, I also want to write paper. I also want to do some research. I'm ready to come. Not at all, I mean, I never expect anything in return. Only expect that you become good team members, you try to learn something, you do something great in your life, I'll be very happy. I always feel one thing, teachers are the most richest person in the world. You have to, everything has two aspects, positive and negative. Some people say that, you know, teachers, anywhere you talk about the teachers, their salary is less, a lot of work pressure is there. But I take it in different way. Teachers are the richest people in the world. How can anyone want to, I mean, would anyone like to reply this? I want you to bring in, please involve. I have only 20 slides, but I can talk about one slide for 1 hour. This is all blessings of, you know, my parents and my great God and my continuous learning process. And the blessings of some senior professors like our distinguished rector. So I want any one of you to answer this. I asked you one question. What was my question? If anyone wants to, contribute something. Why we are richest? See, there are products of the university. And the products are, some of them are engineers, some of them are doctors, some of them are defense scientists, some of them are scientists working in NASA. You know, our students, our children are doing these wonders in the world. We are the richest person. I feel proud that when my student, you know, gets into NASA, gets into some big project, gets into good software industry, I feel very happy. And therefore, I measure my happiness with this wealth. And I always feel that I'm the richest person in the world because I'm a teacher. So, why motivation? How does the research help us in having that feeling? I'll try to talk about. Then research cycle. I'll talk about research cycle. What is a cycle? In which way, in which manner you can do the research work? Then set up skills. What set up skills we can develop based on research? What is research? Why is one thing and what is another thing? Why, what, and how? These are three important terms. I'll begin with why. I'll also talk about what. And I'll also talk about how. What I have planned is last 1 hour, around at 3 o'clock only we'll take break, right? I can keep on talking for 4 hours, 5 hours, non-stop. I mean, I'm always ready. That much energy is always with me. Lot of energy you get when you do such kind of work, I tell you. If I take 3 hours in the morning and you tell me next hour you have to go, and again talk for 3-4 hours, I'm ready. It gives you a lot of enthusiasm, right? So, what, how, and why? So the last 1 hour, what I have planned, at 3 o'clock, we'll have a break for 10 minutes, maximum 10 minutes. And last 50 minutes, if any one of you can bring any research paper, which you are studying, which you are interested to write a review for, give it to me. I'll practically demonstrate how to write a review of a paper. Because the literature review is the most important part of any research work. The research work may be the research grant, it may be research paper, it may be patent or whatever. The most important thing or the most important step with which we begin is always literature review of papers. So I'll talk about, I'll highlight about that thing, last part of today's session. So what is research? Then research for continuous improvement. As I told you, I never feel that I'm improved. Every day I feel that a lot of scope is there for improvement. So how does research help in continuous improvement? Right, designation is one thing. You become prime minister, president of a country. But how do you enjoy your life? How do you lead successful life? That I tell you, that's related to research. I'll tell you practically. I'll try to tell you the research components. What are the major parts of components? What are major components of a research piece? And then, in basis on literature survey, as I already mentioned, that how do we write the review of research papers will be one of my stress, will be one of my emphasis. Then I'll slightly talk about publication, because the professor has cited, professor has read about my introduction, 218. And I do not hesitate in saying that there are different types of publications which are happening. One is standard publication, second is substandard. There are some indexing. You want to publish in which type of journal? You want to publish in which type of conferences? I have a number of papers. I mean, I should not talk about much about me. That's not a good thing. But there are many papers which have been published in Scopus Index and SCI journals out of 20. And none of the journal is paid journal. Because I know all across the world, especially in India, because it's a big country, more than 1.3 million population. The government has made compulsory PhD you have to do. Wherever you make something compulsory, people will try to find out some alternate ways. And there are thousands of journals in India. And everyone writes international journal. And what do they do? Today you submit the paper, next day you will get acceptance, and after 3 days, the paper gets published. You have to pay someone. Why I'm talking all this about these things? Because if out of those 218 papers, which my papers are, none of the paper is published in such kind of journal of conference. So it gives me great pleasure that at least I have not done such kind of work. So that ethical value will also be developed, I tell you. That integrity will also be developed through research. If you really try to do genuinely, and if you don't try to do, I anyhow want my PhD degree, then you will try to find out some alternative means. Give me some source, give me some conference where I will submit, and next week I'll get acceptance. There is no use of that. I'm very junior to professor. I got my PhD award in 2010. This has been 8th year. 7 have now been produced PhD under me. I don't stop doing research. Recently I got a project of $60,000 by the government of India. I never stop. I think no. I should enjoy this life, and I enjoy. Why I'm here, tell me. Why I have come here is because of research. Research brought me here. If research does not exist, I won't come. If I have come here, it's only because of one term, that's research. So I'll be talking about very briefly publication and plagiarism once. Plagiarism, I mean, one should not copy and paste. That also I'll talk about. Then finally, research teaches success process. How to lead successful life. That also is taught by research. If you really want to learn something through the research, that also you can learn. Okay? So that I'll be talking about. So let us begin with great visionaries. What do they say about something in our life? I'll try to connect with the research. Right? I hope you recognize this person. His great personality. If anyone can recognize, I do not have chocolate today, but I can promise that next time I'll bring chocolate for you. Anyone recognizes his personality? Okay, I'll bring another personality. Great visionary. All of you recognize, right? Both are great personalities. This is a monk, Hindu monk, right? His name is Swami Vivekananda. He's an international monk. If you Google Swami Vivekananda, you will find how much he has contributed in US and the European countries. And you know everything about this. Great, great personality. Right? You know that how many people every year are increasing the followers of this great person in India. 30th of April, our Prime Minister talked about 5 minutes about this great person and the contribution to the society. I'm not going to talk about these two great personalities. You will know all about them. Why I'm mentioning their names is, what do they say? I'm trying to connect with the research. am trying to connect with the research. I have read many, many literatures of this person and few literatures of this great person. Whenever I get time, I go to library. I try to find out some books in my library which are written in English because there are very few, and I try to read about two great persons. One cannot be compared with this person. I try to find something and I want to read. I try to read. And second, who is my role model is Dawn Sansoji. Right? So whatever I have read about this person, I have got some gist. And what is the gist? Let me make it complete. Take up one idea. They generally used to say, take up one idea. Don't take many ideas. Just take up one idea. Make that idea your life. Make that one idea your life. I tell you, what is your idea? You take one idea in your life, you want to do this thing, and think of it, dream of it, live on that idea only. Don't deviate yourself. Be focused. And what is required? Let your brain, muscles, nerves, every part of the body be full of that idea. You must be thoroughly dedicated, thoroughly committed to that particular idea. I tell you, no one can stop it. No one can stop anyone to achieve the success. Tell me, this is the story of our personal life. And this is the story in research, I tell you. If I want to do something as a research, what do I do? I'll begin with one idea. And what will I do next? I'll make that idea throughout the life is throughout a cycle. That research will have a cycle. I plan to do this work in 3 years or next 5 years or next 10 years, that will be life. But if it is your personal life, this will be your throughout your life. Take one idea. What is my idea? My idea is to just do a job like a teacher and earn the money. Is it not that my idea is to serve the society? Is it not that to create awareness among the common people of the society? Is it not my duty? So what is my idea? I have to take that one idea. And I have to work very hard, and I have to put all my brains, muscles, everything to that particular idea. What do we do in research? Many of you are very senior teachers, senior professors. I won't try to say that much. Otherwise, you will say that, don't talk that much. But this thing, lines are very simple, but they carry huge meaning, great meaning. You just be dedicated yourself to that idea. This is the requirement of research, I tell you. This is a simple requirement of research. Just focus yourself, okay? So this was about why research. I initiated with the great visionary what they have said. Now, why research is very important? Why research is very important thing? And for that, I have included two things. But I don't want to go into this. If anyone wants, I'll send you. I have given the hyperlink. The professor has read my profile. That was a single page brief profile. This profile is of some 16 pages, and this list of pages is also of 16 pages. And this 16 pages document, I'll just